Good morning, Granadakids! I'm so happy I decided to come to Granadakids this morning.
Oh, me too, and obviously you decided to get dressed.
I did. I decided to wear jeans, a gray shirt, and a hat.
Uh-huh. I decided to eat a healthy breakfast this morning to start my day right.
That's a good decision. Mm-hmm. Did you decide to brush your teeth also?
Indeed, and I decided to brush my hair too.
And I decided not to.
So you decided to wear a hat.
I did.
Mm-hmm.
Did you decide to obey all the traffic rules to come here?
Most of them. Yes, sir, I did.
Awesome.
You know, it is estimated that the average adult makes about 35,000 decisions every day.
Wow, that is a lot of decisions.
That's a lot of decisions. It makes me tired just thinking about that.
Yeah.
How about you? What decisions do you make every day, boys and girls?
And how do you know that you're making the right decision?
Mm.
We'll talk more about that here today at Granadakids.
Granadakids, do you know what a proverb is? It is a statement that gives us practical advice for living wisely. All wisdom comes from God, but some proverbs can be found directly in God's Word, the Bible. That's right. Well, for this activity, I'm going to say 11 proverbs. If you think it is from the Bible, go ahead and stand up. And if you think it is not from the Bible, just stay seated. Let's get started. An apple a day keeps the doctor away. Is that from the Bible? It's pretty wise, but I don't know if it's found in God's Word. What about, trust in the Lord with all your heart and do not lean on your own understanding. That's right. That's found in Proverbs 3:13. When it rains, it pours. Wow, that's pretty deep. But I'm not quite sure that was in the Bible. It is better to be safe than sorry. I'm sure some of you have heard that a few times. I know I have. But is that really in God's Word? Worry weighs us down, but a cheerful word picks us up. Is that in the Holy Book? That's right, Proverbs 12:25. A watched pot never boils. What do you think? First pride, then the crash. The bigger the ego, the harder the fall. Is that in God's Word? Good job. Proverbs 16:18. What about actions speak louder than words? I've heard that a lot. Just as a door turns on its hinges, so a lazy bones turns back over in bed. Is that in God's Word? Nice! Proverbs 26:14. What about haste makes waste? Wow, that's a lot of wisdom there. And it's only a little of all that is available to us. The Bible contains many proverbs for making wise choices and living a life that's pleasing to God. This morning, we'll hear some of them.
Good morning, Granadakids. It's Miss Tracy. Do you remember our big word from last week? Omniscient. Omni means all, and omniscient means all knowing. That's what God is. Let's say our big picture question. What does God know? God knows everything about the past, present, and future. That means that God never forgets anything. He is always aware of what's happening right now. And he is never surprised about things that will happen because God knows everything. All his plans are best. He is perfectly wise and we can trust him. That is great news.
A lot of Proverbs tell us about consequences of right or wrong actions. Like the one about worrying weighs us down. God knows we tend to worry, and he doesn't want us to be weighed down by it. Let's see what consequences you can think of for certain instructions or directions you're given at home, at school, or in the community. Use a dry erase board or a large piece of paper, and then also you're gonna need some markers. Now, what you're gonna do is you are going to divide it into two columns. So you can fold the piece of paper like this, or if you're on the dry erase, just draw a line down the center. So you have two sides, two columns. Now, label the first column directions. And then on the second column, you're gonna put consequences. So first column, directions, second, consequences. Just like so. I'll give you some examples, but see if you can come up with 10 of them on your own. How about, look both ways before crossing the street? That's the direction. The consequence would be, if you don't look, you might get hit by a car, or you might almost get hit by a car. What about don't touch the stove? Why do you think mom and dad tell you keep your hands away from the stove? That's right, because you might get burned. What about wash your hands before eating? This is so important and we need to remember, because on our hands are what? Germs, right? And so we can get sick if we eat with our hands without washing them. And so mom and dad, you know, our teachers, all of the people in our lives that are giving us these directions, we think that it's because they just want to tell us what to do, but in reality, it's for our own good. Pause the video and start thinking. Why do you think we have instructions like these? Some people don't always realize the consequences of some actions. One of the best ways to be wise is to listen and follow instructions. I hope you do. Now, let's hear some from God's Word.
When Solomon became king, he asked God for help to lead the Israelites. God gave King Solomon wisdom to lead his people. People came from far away to hear Solomon's wise words. The Bible teaches that there are two ways to live: a wrong way, doing what is foolish and evil, and a right way, doing what is wise and good.
Solomon wrote thousands of wise sayings called Proverbs. He also wrote more than 1,000 songs. In the book of Proverbs, Solomon said to love and worship God. He told people how to make wise decisions. If people listened to God's words and did what God told them to do, God would bless them and protect them. If they did not listen to God's words and obey them, they would make bad decisions and face consequences for their sins. They would not be happy, healthy, or get along well with others.
Trust in the Lord with all your heart, Solomon wrote in Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5. He also wrote other wise sayings like, a gentle answer turns away anger, but a harsh word stirs up wrath. And even a young man is known by his actions, by whether his behavior is pure and upright. Some people do not always listen to God's words. Solomon wrote, fools hate wisdom and instruction. He also wrote, "A fool does not want to learn, but only wants to say what he thinks. And a fool does whatever he thinks is right, but a wise person listens to advice."
Solomon wrote another book in the Bible called Ecclesiastes. The book of Ecclesiastes has wisdom for people too. Solomon wrote about money and work and how to live a good life. Many people seek after these things, but these things do not truly satisfy. The most important thing, Solomon said, is to love and obey God.
Solomon taught that there is a time for everything, a time to give birth and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to uproot, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to tear down and a time to build, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance. Solomon also wrote a poem about love. This poem is called Song of Songs. Solomon wrote this poem to celebrate God's wise plan for love and marriage.
Wisdom in the Bible shows us how to be like Jesus in how we live, how we speak, and how we think. But wisdom cannot save us. Only Jesus, who perfectly followed God's wise plan, can rescue us from sin.
The Bible is such a big book. Where do you begin to read and understand it all? Did you know that there are 31 chapters in the book of Proverbs? And there are 31 days in most months of the year. So you and your family could read one chapter a day each month. For example, if today is August 14th, you would read together chapter 14. How about that? It's a great idea. Give it a try. Think of all that wisdom you would be learning. King Solomon wrote almost 50 chapters of the Bible in Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, and the Song of Solomon. But also, the Bible says in Matthew chapter 12, verse 42, "One greater than Solomon is here." You know who that is, right? Get to know Jesus, boys and girls. Jesus not only taught God's wisdom, he displayed it and he lived it perfectly.
Good morning, Granadakids. I'm Mrs. Sarah.
I am Betty, and this is Fish, Fishelstein, and for Gerber Mew.
We see in the books of wisdom in the Bible, Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, and the Song of Solomon, that there are two ways to live, the wise way and the foolish way. God gives us wisdom through his word, through the Holy Spirit, and through other wise Christians. Our key passage reminds us that God enjoys giving wisdom, and he doesn't just give a little, he gives a lot. If you need wisdom, the solution is easy. Ask God. Let's read what James says.
If any of you lacks wisdom, he should ask God, who gives to all generously and ungrudgingly, and it will be given to him. James 1:5.
So if you need wisdom, the solution is easy. Ask God. Let's sing this great reminder.
If any of you lacks wisdom, he should ask God. I'm Lexi. Please bow your heads and pray with me.
Father God, you are wise, powerful, and good. You know all there is to know, and you always do what is best. We praise you because of who you are and what you have done. Help us to obey you. Give us wisdom to know what you want and courage to obey your commands. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
This little activity is called Listen Closely. Your teacher or parent will whisper a short statement to one child. The child will then turn and whisper the same statement to the child by him, and so on until the last child has heard the statement. Now that child will say out loud what they heard. Pause the video, give it a try, and see what happens. So, how did it go? Now we're gonna switch it up a little bit. Play a second round, but this time your leader will write down the statement and you can read it. This time, there was almost no chance that you would say the wrong statement because it was written down, not just whispered, right? Isn't it great that God has given us his written word so that we won't get it wrong and we can look at it at any time? What a blessing that is. Because Solomon wrote down his Proverbs, many people, including you and me and everyone really, can learn about wisdom and God. Yes! Such great news.
Hey boys and girls, so happy and glad you are here with us today, that you decided to be here with us. That was a wise decision. Boys and girls, today's lesson was about wisdom is fearing the Lord and obeying his word. Wisdom in the Bible shows us how to be like Jesus and how we live and how we speak and how we think. And so to be like Jesus, we must be with Jesus. A wise person will see his or her need for Jesus, Savior and King. But wisdom cannot save us. Only Jesus can, who perfectly followed God's wise plan. He can rescue us from our sins. Boys and girls, I hope you trust in Jesus with all of your heart, mind, body, and soul, and that you become wise. Become wise and to obey him and follow him. God bless you guys. Have a great week. Bye.